Did you get any trash barrel?
Yeah, time's 7:30.
I got mine, yeah.
Welcome to Pembroke Conservation Commission meeting.
July 4th.
They were delivering right out, Sunday, before that, they were delivering on Sunday, too.
Well, there's still probably 400 of them up to the high school.
Yeah.
That they still gotta deliver, but I got two of them.
You guys ready?
Did you get two?
Okay. We have our first public hearing at 7:40. But, first of all, I guess we can talk about Rick's trees. We have some trees in Rick's emergency order from, at the Herring Run. Do you wanna tell us what happened on the roof?
We went down, we were there. I contacted the person from Boston, who works for a large company, and he's going to be here at the next meeting to enlighten us from the parsnips, what can be done all the way up through the care of the trees, what he does. Very good at it, and we'll go from there. But he did just talk to them and said that immediately they've already passed their eggs and onto the trees, so there's no more danger of losing the leaves right now. So we've gotten through that phase. It's gonna give us a plan for long-term care of the trees that are affected. In 2 weeks, we'll be here and discuss that, and hopefully some of the parsnips, that's what we can do.
And who was the senior song? We saw?
Michael X, Eccles.
Eccleston?
No, the guys that went to North Pole.
Santa Claus?
No, it's not Eccleston, it's very close, I gotta find it.
No, it's not Eccleston.
Shackleton, North Pole guys, it's Shackleton. No, it's history place, Mike Shackleton.
Mary, can you make a point on our next meeting before that, if you don't already?
He's doing the workup right now, I wanna walk around right now.
So does he wanna come in first? We have an appointment at our next hearing for Ed Thorne and Leah Stanton to talk about, she's from West Virginia.
Right.
So the engineer's coming, you're saying, with him?
Yeah, that'd be good for him to be there.
The restoration of the Herring Park, that part? That'd be good.
Do you wanna have him speak before them or after them?
What time are they here, because he works hard.
I have a set of time for Ed to come in, and what he's looking for.
Why don't we start early, you know, early this time for him? Then I can go up there with him, come here directly, and work from there here. And he knows all the new, he's all certified licensed and everything, has to do all that stuff.
Well, we're down at the Herring Run, there's some new trees that were planted there, and I don't know, do you know who planted those trees? Was there by the memorial area?
Probably Rosa Sharon?
Yeah. Do you know who planted those, Bob?
The little row of them there?
Yeah.
That was like 3 years ago, and it was...
Oh, was it? Yeah, that was quite a while ago. I thought something was something new.
Well, no, they're gonna be trees pretty soon, and they're invasive.
Yes.
So why are we planting invasive trees there?
Because we were just trying to pretty the park up. That was a donation the gentleman made. He actually planted some in front of the community center, planted some at the cemeteries. I can't think of the gentleman's name.
They proliferate so well in his yard that he decided to give them the rest of the town to proliferate.
No, we just thought it'd add some color down there.
No, but he had a big thing on the 300. I didn't fight him, but I just said I was not privy to doing that, it wasn't good. I wasn't gonna mess with what somebody wanted to do on the 300. So I didn't get involved, I just wouldn't, he offered them to me.
And I don't believe that we were told that they were invasive at the time they were planted there.
No, they weren't. I talked to Billy and a few others and said that, and...
They're not invasive, or they are?
No, they are invasive, they're on the list. But, I think there's, the parsnips and things are much bigger issues than saving the big trees. But that was my opinion. The guy has them all over his yard, and he's like, likes them, and he wanted to share. And it was in the spirit of the right thing, so I sedated and said, you know, do whatever.
Those are the same ones with the veterans farms?
Yes.
That you never grow?
Yeah.
To mow them down?
Most of them didn't make it.
Daryl, thank you.
When we saw four of them across where the landing strip is?
The deer, not the tree.
Oh.
You're flying!
No.
Does anyone else have anything in the meantime? We've got 5 more minutes here. Sharon? About the, we have ongoing business.
There was one thing about that bridge. It just definitely needs to be replaced ASAP.
Right.
Because even that was like, it's not, it's...
It's really falling down. Who do we see? Do we see you to get that fixed, or?
No, we gotta find out who's coming up with the money to pay for it.
Okay.
Last time it was, the only reason I got involved last time, because it was like 4 days before the fish fry. And...
It was emergency.
My last conversation with Mr. Thorne was he wanted to try to wait until after his 25th or whatever it is, hearing with the engineers and all, because he doesn't want to go doing a bridge that isn't going to be part of...
This is unsafe at this point, because somebody could easily fall in.
Should put a note saying...
That's just, that's liability, I wouldn't put a note.
We should either close it down or fix it.
We'll have to look and maybe we'll just remove it. I'll have to go down tomorrow and take a look at it and see what we can, maybe we can get a machine in there, just take it out for now. Because I know, I think we spent $1,400, somewhere right in there, when we had the other one rebuilt, just in materials.
Oh, wow.
All right.
But like I said, the only reason the other one was done, it was, I think we were within a week of the fish fries. So it was like, hurry up, if not, you're not gonna have access.
Way to get over.
Yeah.
It would've been a nightmare, so it was a must do with that.
Yep.
So do we need to call somebody about that, or can you...
No, I'll go down tomorrow and take a look and maybe we'll have George, if George is around, we'll just get George to get on there, so we have a little backup. If anybody questions why the bridge was removed, we'll get George to condemn it if George is around tomorrow and Bill respect it.
It's gonna continually, whatever you do, that's gonna decay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, how you say, you don't, if you don't get his word, they're gonna say, well, what made you deem it was unsafe?
Yeah, what structure?
So we, if we get the building inspector to say, yeah, it shouldn't be there, we're just covering everybody's butt by saying, yeah, we removed it due to safety, that's all.
Yep.
Also, on the other concrete overpass by the old first fish where one rail was replaced on the right, it was...
Yeah, I was able to go get one rail over at,
Cleaning on the other one.
Yeah, that's not that good either.
The other one is like, ready to go, and a little, portly, as they say, but, it might be looked at also.
Just saying, all of these were run by the town administrator early spring, late winter, and basically said, hold off.
Yep.
Somebody could get hurt now, it's...
Well, like I said, it moved about 20 inches when I went clean on it.
But the other part of it is, do you not want anything there over that little, you know?
At this point, it'd be better than having that bridge.
No, no, I'm saying where Rick is talking about, where the three railings are, two railings, I forget what it is. At least it kind of keeps people in the middle of the bridge. If you take it away, they're gonna go, oh.
Oh, no, no, you definitely want rails there, absolutely. It's only the top rail, it's not, you know...
So, we'll look at it tomorrow, see what we can do.
Okay, 7:40, do you have an RDA hearing for 36 High Street, Mr. Wright?
I have.
I'm not sure what I need to inform you, I just want permission to replace a rotted wall of railroad ties, which, as you can see in the pictures that were provided to you in your package, I believe you all have that. You can see that it looks like it's double because it's a reflection in the pond. It is not double. So it isn't really that bad, but it's pretty bit rotten out, and we want to replace it with a structure that would be a lot better. It would be block.
Before we get going, I just need to recuse myself from this because I'm in a butter.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, live across the street.
37?
Yep.
Oh, you built the house since I bought the place?
Yeah.
I got the place, it was a cottage, I got it from my uncle's estate. Many summers I was down there, it's still a cottage. Even though you probably will admit it doesn't look much like a cottage since we took it over. I took down 12 trees, put in a complete and entire Title V. I've spent over six years now to get the cottage ready. Now we'd like to get back down to the pond where we were always able to when I was a kid, which is a long time ago. Be able to go down and, you know, like swim in the pond and even possibly, you know, put a little rowboat down there or whatever. But that's basically all this is about, request for determination of applicability is to determine if I am legal to do what I want to do. Is that correct?
Yeah.
What materials should you use?
It's part of the package. It says this, it'll be stone. I mean, stone. It'll be 3-foot retaining wall using alpha wall or pro or similar block.
This is big breeze.
And that's the design for it. Should be in your package, I believe.
Can I see that, Andy?
Yeah, this isn't the one.
Oh, that isn't the one. Oh, okay.
Oh, no. Actually, this is a septic repair plan that was.
The septic plan, unfortunately, says that there's a concrete wall. Said existing concrete retaining wall. It isn't. And I never really noticed that because, of course, we were on the other side of the cottage doing the Title V up here, which Dan Smith did. I just want to replace it because.
Sorry, that's no big deal if you drop that.
You don't want it anyway, right?
No. We're going to have to do some digging, though, to set anything there.
That's
a reflection, but even to start something, they're going to have to do.
What kind of footing is a wall going to be?
They're going to have to do excavating to get a footing in there.
Right
here.
A concrete pad footing with a drain.
That's about a few years instead of the wood. That'll last a lot longer than the wood.
Exactly. it'll last for my kids and grandkids.
Yeah.
My uncle had the cottage for quite a while. He was 97 when he died in 2009. And his parents built it, the original cottage. It does not even resemble what it looked like. It was on cedar pilings. It was built, it was bought from the New England Cranberry Growers Association that owned the pond at the time. Used to drain it and fill their bogs to harvest the cranberries, and then it's spring-fed steps of a beautiful soft pond. It's completely spring-fed. It's one of the cleanest in the whole area. It's all the South Shore, so.
Little sandy. Little sandy too.
Little sandy too, yeah.
Who'll be doing the work?
His name is Sean Buckley, and he is, you have my, which way did mine go?
This one came out of, it must be over that way, because this one came out of here.
You were looking at the, you passed it that way.
It's always not spread through all of our records.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a set of plans right here.
Yeah, But again, like I said, there was a mistake in the plan by, remember the people who did it during the.
Grady Consulting did the plan.
Yeah, see that's that line there is the water line because it's a reflection.
Yep. Yep.
How high is the new wall going to be? How high is the new wall going to be?
3 feet.
Okay, so about the same?
3 feet, about the same. Yeah, the same. I think the present wall is like 27 inches or something like that.
Are we going to have a above grade structure to stop lawn chemicals from coming right down?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we've done nothing there anyway except what's there now.
A drain pipe going to be installed.
I don't even have a lawn. Okay. Just over the septic system.
Drain pipe.
Where's going to drain pipe just for the stone behind it?
I think the funniest thing I ever heard was when my uncle owned the property, he had a cesspool. It was on the side of the cottage. And when he closed down for the winter, the first last thing he did was he flushed the dye pack in the toilet. Just to make sure nothing came up in the pond.
Yeah.
So, but They didn't let me keep that. I had to. My cousin and I split the cost for that when she sold it to me as the estate.
That's when you had to do it when it was sold?
Pardon?
When it was sold?
Oh, yeah, it was done before.
I think they got a lot of
issues. I paid the part of it, but she
getting that footing in.
I have a little bit of a problem
in
figuring how we're going to get the footing in and work. Otherwise, the area. I'd like to know from the installer.
He told me there's no problem coming down to the association property.
Yeah, but
I was the president
by getting it out
for 1 year and getting it right back up the hill. Yeah.
See, my objective is to make sure we don't get any of the material into the pond, and it only looks like we've got a short distance to work there.
It's no different than we make the contractors do. We just did it over on the culvert we just made and replaced. We made him come out and sandbag out into the water so that nothing got out there.
That's a good idea.
And those were 500-pound sandbags.
They're silt.
No, sandbags.
What they call, that's what I had here for putting in the septic system. What are those?
You had silt sack.
Silt sack.
Yeah, that was just a barrier. We're talking just anything to stop any runoff or any digging here.
Salt comes in, it pours, just everything rushes in. Trying to avoid that type of
thing. So what are you worried about rushing in?
Silt.
During the construction?
Debris, material.
Oh.
From the site.
Does he have a timeline?
No.
The
you're going to dig in the ground, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's going to expose ground. Say it rains, washes right into the pond without a barrier. It can blow in, wash in.
I mean, I'm not a conservationist. I'm an assessor.
Honestly, I don't see how he's going to get this dug down deep enough to set the quarter.
She's going to go what?
I know property. I mean, I know that.
No, but
I'm
just saying he's got to remove.
Oh yeah.
And if anything,
those look like pretty substantial blocks.
There's nothing in it.
He's going to have to. I would imagine.
Always been this.
He's going to need at least a 12-inch.
That's how it is.
To set this thing on.
We're just talking for during the construction.
Yeah.
To make sure the stuff doesn't hit the wall.
Yeah. He's a licensed contractor, licensed landscaper. I'm sure he is bonded.
That's the thing. The biggest concern here would be that the materials that are disturbed.
I certainly would not want to jeopardize it.
Okay, that's all I'm trying to do, sir.
I certainly would not want to jeopardize anything to do with the pond. I bought the property and.
It's a beauty.
I would be more comfortable talking to the contractor and getting his idea of how he's going to do this without getting the materials.
I had not contracted with him because I didn't know if I was going to get permission, and I wouldn't open to a contract with somebody that I didn't have a license, you know,
a contract with. It's not so much the license or the fact that he's bonded or insured, is we don't want it to happen in the first place, and that's our job, is to condition these jobs so that it doesn't happen, not that we can take
somebody
care of it afterwards.
Somebody has my package, could I?
And not remediate something after
I don't know.
Is that the one Rick was looking at when I was watching?
Yeah, I think this is the one.
Yeah, I have another one right there.
Can we pass an order of conditions and leave that as a requirement that it's blocked off during the construction?
That's why I would like whoever's doing the work to get their thoughts before we just tell them what we need to do it, because he may be doing about it some other way.
Right. Permission to repair the wall was not an issue, but we just want to know what he's going to do in order to protect
the pond.
Right. I mean, he says here, filter fabric will also be used to avoid intrusion of soil into crushed stone. Drain pipe will be installed. It will also include wall caps, using geosynthetic fabric in backfill for stabilization, backfilled with 3/4 crushed stone aggregate.
Yeah, that's all. That's all in the wall.
The point is, that says he's going to dig everything out, okay?
Yeah.
Legal wording.
That's and we cost. Move everything and put a new in so it's not touching anything that's behind it.
To where? And any materials he's going to need, where is he going to store them? And how is he going to stop migrating materials towards the water before it happens? It's downhill, right. On the water.
You tell me what I have to do, and if I have to spend another $2,000 or $3,000 for him to come out and sit before you six people and the conservation director, I don't know.
On the good side, sir, you're removing some, you know, railroad ties and
yes,
upgrading and doing a good thing. And,
because if anybody walked on them now, they're going to crush them. They're going to cause the stuff to go into the pond that I'm trying to get out of it.
You're removing things that really shouldn't have been there. We all did it. Everybody did this. Things are different now. So you are upgrading and getting rid of some.
Very much so.
You're doing a good thing then, okay? I want you to know that. Just, I'm not fighting you.
Okay, I just want you to know that I bought the place for $150,000. And it was a piece of crap.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah. We can see.
And, no, the house and the whole property. And I have upgraded it to so much that I probably put close to $300,000 in it. Including a complete Title V. I use it from April to November. That's all. It's mainly for my daughter, son-in-law, grandkids. I have the joy of it. I want them to have the joy of it.
All right, excuse me. The one thing that we
I'm
have to consider...
I'm not trying to dirty anything up. I'm not trying to go over the law. I thought I was doing everything legal. I didn't realize I was going to have to spend money to bring this gentleman into
the only thing that we're having a problem with is during the construction... We want to have some kind of barrier. So could you ask the construction person to come in and talk to us?
I can't see why you'd have to, if he wants to come in and say this is what
I don't have a problem with that.
Yeah, right. Okay. I don't have a problem with that,
but I don't know, again, I've not contracted, he's already told me that this job is going to cost about $14,000 and another $7,000 to replace the old cement stairs that you can see there that are totally unsafe.
Yeah.
Okay, and I'm doing nothing but upgrading everything, and I'm spending a vast amount of money for it. And I'm protecting all of you and all of my neighbors, the entire association, and the entire pond.
But you're not protecting the pond right now. We don't have a plan for protecting the pond while you have construction. That's all we want.
That's all we want.
That's all we want.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's all I have to do.
We'd just like the gentleman to come in and go over his construction sequence. That's all.
I would suggest also, with what you just said, that. Is that it says replace stairs in our, does it say it in our thing?
Yes, it does.
Okay, I didn't read it. If it hadn't, we hadn't said anything about stairs, but it says replace stairs, all right.
That was added by your office good secretary.
As long as we catch it, yeah, just so it's in there, so nobody can say
okay.
We didn't.
If I say it wasn't covered, then you got to go through it again. So it's,
yeah.
We're trying to work with you here.
I know, and I've been trying to work with the town all along.
Well. We need to know who's going to do the work and how.
Okay, we have another public hearing coming up. So do we need to vote on that, Bobby? Or
no, well, I say right now, I think we just need to continue it because we definitely need something to protect the pond edge while the work is being done. Now, Scott talked about how with the state, we make them put 500-pound sandbags out there. Well, it might be as simple as a 12-inch silt sock at the water's edge or hay bales, but we have to have something that says this is what we're going to do to help to protect the area while it's open.
Yeah.
Because as you said, Rick, once it rains and it's open, everything goes downhill and it ends in the pond.
Then it's a real problem you don't want.
Right.
So can we have a motion for continuance?
Okay. We have our next hearing on the 25th of July.
We need to continue this hearing.
I'll second it.
Do you want to contact him and see when he can get here before we move it out?
Second.
I'll contact him.
Okay.
And I'll get back to the office.
Yeah, there's no. All we want to know is just what his plans are. There's no.
I've only been since 2009.
Right.
It's not done.
Right. We have
but
no
has
issues.
This been,
let's get her done.
This is the first time this has come before us, correct, to replace this wall?
I'm sorry, I'm 70 years old,
yeah,
I'm retired, and I've had a heck of a time trying to do this.
This
and now I've hit another stumbling block.
It's not a stumbling block, sir. We just
gonna dirty anything up.
We just need to talk to the contractor.
Yeah.
That's all.
Sure.
You're saying you're not gonna, and I know you're not.
Gentlemen, question. You're an appointed board.
Yep.
Excuse me. An elected board.
An appointed board.
Appointed board.
You're not elected by
the... No, we're not. We're appointed. We're appointed by the selectmen.
Appointed by the selectmen or elected by the people. And then you, in turn, hire a conservation agent.
Yes. Which he's got more experience than the rest of us on this book.
He is your word, your agent on the street.
That's right.
We don't have an actual good plan, and we have pictures, okay? We need dimensions.
Okay, I'm sorry. I only was told to provide, well, your dimensions are on the plan.
Yeah, we're finding the applicability, like you said. Now we're going to discuss the applicability we have.
No, we're not. We're going to move on to the next issue. Can we vote on that?
Well, what it doesn't show us is the footing he's putting in for the wall and how he's going to put the footing in.
I make a motion.
This does not say anything about the footing and what he's putting in?
I make a motion that we...
This here?
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
No, it doesn't. It just shows you a picture.
Go ahead, Rick.
It doesn't tell us what he's going to put in for a footing.
And then over here, the explanation as to what he's going to do.
It does not.
July 25th.
It does, says nothing about a footing.
At 7:30. Anybody second it?
Do you second it?
I'm sorry, Rick.
Can we have a vote?
We made a motion to continue.
July 25th at 7:30.
7:30.
July what?
25th.
At 7:30. July 25th, 7:30. Continue and...
With?
Further discussion and more information.
Okay, can we have a vote? All in favor?
Aye.
All the same. One extension? Liz?
No.
Mr. Clark, excuse me. When are you in the office?
I can be in the office or anywhere, whenever you want me.
Okay, I will make a call.
Yeah.
And I invite all of your members to please drop by 36 High Avenue. Take a look at this building. Take a look at the property I'm dealing with. Personally.
Nope.
Have you done that?
The only thing we're concerned about is the wall.
Have any of you done that? I'm just asking.
We haven't, to be honest, we haven't asked permission to...
Have any of you actually done that?
We haven't asked permission for you to...
Okay, excuse me, sir. We have other business to do, so we have to close this.
Now that we know we have permission to enter the property, we will stop by.
Okay. We have to have permission. Just can't stop by. It's yours.
Okay, it's now 7:50. Can we have Amrad, 73 Taylor Street, Mr. Cook? Yeah, he probably knows her.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Hello.
He needs to watch his cards closely. This gentleman needs to watch very closely on this job.
You're almost there. We had a little bit more detail.
Yeah. I was a little less excited.
Good evening, members of the commission. Brad Holmes with Environmental Consulting and Restoration, assisting Merrill Corporation with an ANRAD application filed for the property at 73 Taylor Street. The property is owned by Sue Cook and her family. It's a large piece of land off the western edge of Taylor Ave. It's approximately 24.6 acres. It's a really large piece of land, a significant wetland resource area that abuts the Stump Pond. Off to the northwest. What we've done is we filed an ANRAD application to confirm the location of the bordering vegetated wetland shown here in green. That's been delineated by me in 2014 and recently went out and made sure the flags were up in May and rehung them, the pieces, so that it's easily identified in the field. The property is a nice sloping woodland property. It slopes right down to the wetland. It's a nice wetland line. It's actually a pretty property. It's a nice wetland line to see in the field. It's not a very difficult site.
Coleman property.
Excuse me?
Jill Coleman property.
Is it? So we're looking to get the commission's approval to confirm the location of the wetland resource areas so that she can move forward with her plans, which I'm not involved with as a wetland scientist, but here for the ANRAD.
Where did you get that information about where the wetland is?
That was delineated by myself. These are all the wetland flags that I placed in the field that was located by survey and plotted and put on the plan. So it's an instrument survey to locate the wetland delineation that I performed in the field in accordance with the regulations And that's a board okay, on the line. There's also what we haven't asked for as part of the ANRAD, but it is shown here on the plan. There is a FEMA line, FEMA A zone. It's on the plan. We didn't ask for it to be confirmed as part of the ANRAD. It is on the location.
When we have a piece of property with a ANRAD or a long line, we ask that proponent authorize us at their expense to hire someone to check it. We can go out and check it if anyone feels they are so qualified to do so and want to walk. We haven't done it in quite a few years because, you know, if we don't know what we're looking at, then there's no sense just going for a bunny walk. And the law allows us to ask the proponent to pay for someone to check. And usually, sometimes they'll go with Brad, or some people like to do it by themselves. And then if anything is not correct, then the two of you get together and come up with an agreeable line that we can look at. So I would suggest, if that is your people, are they susceptible to hiring someone else to
work with you? Sure, I understand that's common practice, especially on a larger piece of property. If it's something that the commission would like to walk, I can do that with you guys. If it goes to a consultant review, we're suitable with that too. That's the process, so it's understandable.
My only concern is the last time we, as a commission, walked a large thing, we spent like six Saturdays doing it, and many of the wives were not overly happy about the sixth Saturday that you're saying, I'm leaving you in the morning, we're going out walking in the woods. That's why we figured it was better to do it professionally and get it done. We have, usually we ask for at least two bids for the work. Is that correct, Mary? Two or three?
We do ask. Sometimes you guys choose a consultant. Sometimes we just ask for a couple of bids. I think you do have to ask for several bids if it's going to be over $5,000.
It shouldn't be that. I think it's better to ask for bids. We usually will run it by you first and get agreement. And usually we want the check in hand, Mary. In other words, if we're hiring the consultant, we want the money up front.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, we'll ask for the
yeah,
money.
Because we were burnt too many times.
What is the purpose of applying for an ANRAD?
Lets them know for sure where the line is.
Where it is.
Once we accept it, it's there. Then they can do their engineering from that.
Okay. So
otherwise, they
future development down the line possibility or something along those lines.
Right. Okay. It gives a property owner the peace of mind.
Their options.
Right. Yes. Later on, whether it's who knows if it's next week or 2 years down the line. If they come in with a proposal here, there's not the claim, well, hey, we don't agree with that, we're moving it 100 feet landward, and then everybody's like, well, possibly.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Right, so it's a good process. Sometimes I think it gets to be a painful process for everybody. I don't think that's the way it used to be, but it is a good process.
I'll move that we ask for at least two bids to look at this line, to verify this line. And when we get the bids, we'll get with Brad. You can communicate with Brad, and then we can authorize a check from someone. And once it's here, we can tell them go ahead.
Right. Do you have any idea who you might be requesting bids for at this time, or
Usually Brad Holmes is one of the people that we...
That would work.
I'll second Bobby's motion.
You may not know at this point, that's fine.
Yeah.
And this would, before you send bids out, if you would just let me know, because there are instances where I do work with other consultants or about ongoing projects, I just don't want there to be a conflict.
All right.
Sure.
All right, well, why don't we let Mary work with you?
Sure.
In getting some bids.
Yeah, we don't usually, we have three people on our list.
Brooks Monroe. Brooks. Brooks Monroe. I'm naming ones that just come out that I, one way or the other, just names it.
So if Mary comes up with a list, she can go over the list with you to make sure there's no conflict.
Right, that would be great. Those are all qualified individuals. The only one I would ask, as far as me to avoid would be Lenore, because we're involved in a DEP ongoing dispute, and it's ongoing. I'd rather not let that be a conflict.
Okay, understandable, yeah.
But other than that, I don't have any other conflicts.
Okay.
We need a vote to ask for the...
Bob made the motion, Scott seconded it, then we discussed it.
So when do you want to come down?
Okay.
We have a meeting on the 25th, and then the meeting after that will be on the 8th of July.
I would say the 8th of July. I don't think that there would be time to have...
See, it would be the 8th of August.
The 8th of July, we're in trouble.
Right. Yep. True.
See, we're going backwards here. We're supposed to be going forward.
It's all good. Yep. I'm in the same state of mind. It's all good.
I know, it's going too quick.
That's it.
July 8th, 7:40.
August
8th.
It feels like it's not.
I screwed you up.
Ready? Take two. And roll.
Okay, July 8th.
August 8th.
August 8th.
Yeah, I'd be a little overly optimistic for the 25th, I think, by the time somebody was hired and was able to review it and get it reported.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll start with messing on the 25th.
Okay, so
motion to continue to August 8th at 7:40.
Seconded by Scott.
No, who made it?
Oh, Bob.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, we've couple of discussions here.
Looking at the layout of the front of my house lot. I see what they wanted to do there.
It's a beautiful piece of property. So there's like a main house and then a secondary house. Big company or a big barbecue and all that sort of thing.
Because I'll be selling
here. Okay. Thank you.
$5 on me. I don't suppose she'll take that for the whole show.
No, probably not.
Well, that's it.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Okay. Our first discussion is the reorganization of the board. Do we have anyone to say?
As the selectmen have said, they'd like the boards to change leadership every year. I think I'd like to nominate Andy Stevenson for chairman for next year.
Thank you.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye. Congratulations, whether you like it or not.
Thank you. Thank
you. All good now?
I don't know what's good, what's bad. I still know the same before I walked in.
Who seconded it?
I did.
Oh. Yes, since you were on paper. Congratulations.
Okay, do we have any other officers that we need to?
Oh, yeah, we should have a vice chair and a...
I nominate Rick Mountain for vice chair.
Second.
What a millicent person.
Okay.
I like it. A little vinegar and salt and pepper all over the top.
And when I leave the room, we should have somebody to take notes.
Not Rick.
There would be a clerk.
Who's good with penmanship? Because it's not me. Wow, you'd be doing double duty. Chairman and
I can read and write, so if I need a volunteer, I would do that.
Yeah.
Again, it suggests that if we do get to a problem where there, Mary or whoever is, isn't, someone isn't here to take minutes, that we use the recording and everybody kind of jot down what they think is happening, because sometimes when someone listens to a recording that hasn't been here, they don't always hear what really went on.
I have three of them that go every place when I leave.
So anybody else here? That's it?
That's it.
It's all yours.
Oh, it's effective now?
Yeah.
Oh.
We got some minutes from last week.
Yes. I assume we all reviewed the minutes from last week that we postponed. The minutes from June 6th to June 20th and June 27th, 2016. Oh, that's new.
Yeah.
Oh, but I did read those. Those were in the thing here. Those were in the right here. Pretty short one to read.
Yeah,
there
we go.
Yeah. Has everybody had time to read and review from the 27th also? You know, the other ones are previous. That was a relatively short one.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll give that a few more minutes then. So the 6th and the 20th were left over from last week.
Yep.
Okay, so we need motions.
I move that we accept the minutes of the 6th and the 20th. Is that what the two dates were?
Yes, June 16th and June 20th.
June 16th and 20th.
Yep.
My second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Ayes have it. It's official. What else?
If there's any administrative business from my dad. Well, we can't talk about it if you'd like to.
I wasn't really following along, sorry.
I wasn't either, so. Yeah, we have the planning board decision on 49 Cross Street. What was that, Mary, the planning board decision on 49 Cross Street?
That was in the mail. Yeah.
Okay, that was last week.
That was all just the stuff.
Okay, that's it.
Correspondence to Plymouth County Water District Commission. Did we talk about that? Did that get? That's the Brockton Water, right?
Oh yeah, that was the letter that I wrote.
Right. And you were going to send me the address.
I did.
You did not.
Yes, I did on Friday.
Okay. So you just didn't get it. You'll send it again.
No, I sent it back to you today. Said you forgot to let me know there.
And I sent you sent me last week. You asked for the address, and I sent you the address. I think I must have sent it or something.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
So we'll take care of
that. That can be from Indy.
Okay, we'll put it on for next time.
Okay. Ongoing business, the Wild Pasta. We covered it there.
Yep.
Mackey's at Ball Fields on Valley Street. That's still continuing on.
In case anyone was wondering, when Brad Holmes said he had a conflict, it was on the Valley Street project. Lenore is our wetlands on that, and he is the other botanist involved, so that was why he was taking on that one.
I've never seen him for that. Okay. Financial report. Everybody's read all the mail, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I don't know if anyone even read the OOC for Route 53 after it was done, but I thought it was very good. We're getting, so we're pinning them down. I like, we deal with Mass DOT. I think it may be one of our more difficult people to deal with lately, because they're like squirmy. They try to get out of anything that you haven't put down in black and white.
Yep.
Even when you put it down, they try to find a way to go around it.
Or under it.
Or under it. Or uphill when it's going downhill. We do still have problems with Route 14, but they aren't ready to be brought back before the board. But I think we may end up with a fight there.
And would it just to not have the riprap down the end?
Yeah. We may, your letter you just wrote to the water district, we may need a letter like that to Mass DOT saying, folks, you know, we've spent a lot of money trying to clean our lakes.
Yeah, and that we don't want.
You know, come on and stop trying to, you know, put the stuff right back into them when we're spending money to take, to clean it up. It's not to that point yet, but I mean, that, my opinion is that's where it's gonna end up, because
poor planning shouldn't have to result in all that road runoff going right down into that stream and going right out into the pond.
I know if anyone's driven by there, just the, I think it's three outfalls that we couldn't get them to change when the plan came out. That, I mean, no matter what, and boy, do they look like hell. They look like hell on the side of the road. They are monstrous. I mean, I wish they would get some bushes and stuff and at least try to hide them a little bit, because they do look bad.
The one at the end,
especially when we're trying to clean the pond up, and you know, here we are. We did what we could. It's not this board's fault. We did everything we could. We just, Mass DOT refused to do anything in that area.
At the end of Wampatuck and Mattakeesett, their PA land is actually, he's put Jersey barriers up temporarily there. But he's actually pushing for a guardrail, because originally there was no guardrail slighted for that area. And he said by the time he puts a sidewalk in there, it's going to be a very sharp slope. So they are going for an order of conditions change, I guess, to have guardrail installed there. But the Jersey barriers there are temporary. He felt it was a safety issue.
Yeah, there's no question right there.
So
Sharon asked about there's a lot of wood that's cut down. Can we use any of that in the restoration of the herring run for benches and whatnot? Do we have access to that?
The homeowner has first choice to it. Then the rest of it, it really isn't that good. Most of anything that the homeowner doesn't take, they're hauling to the Monroe Street pit. So if there's something you think is usable, you can, once it's all down there, you can go down the pit and look and see if you think there's something usable. Looking at what they're cutting down, it's pretty much firewood. That's about it.
Cavitated trees we can make drums out of.
Yeah,
that's about it.
I think you'll find,
too.
Where do
you want them dropped in your house?
Yeah. Any mill person would not really like to be milling anything that's taken off the sides of the road, because there's a too big a chance of finding metal objects buried in the trees.
Like the chainsaws that try to get through the ash?
But like I said, whatever the homeowner isn't taking, they're going to bring to the Monroe Street pit. So
we should get on there and take a look?
If
we need wood for that, I'm sure either Newcomb or another tree company would provide us wood for that process.
What, to make furniture?
Yeah, Adirondack type benches and such. A dugout canoe.
It's all going to be milled and dried and everything else.
No, Adirondack is basically rough furniture, not fully milled.
And it's cheap and impressive.
Milling's expensive right now.
Yeah,
it is.
Especially if you hit metals.
Yeah.
Oh, anything is.
I think right now most of them are getting, for pine, they're getting 45 cents a board foot to mill it. To buy it, you're about at 85 to 90 cents a board foot. It's tough to say it, though. Even if you cut it down, you take it to the mill. The prices are high because we lost Thompson's mill. He sold out over in Norwell. So you got Dean Copeland, and then I believe it's Zanaboni over in Cava.
All right, who needs some pine wood?
Oh, really? I don't know. There's plenty of pine at the pit right now, but it didn't. None of it came from this job. There was another job going on.
So we have resources we could look at in the future?
Yes.
No high school drainage basin, nothing. They get big piles out there, my wife says. She's out to walk my dogs every day.
It's actually at the Monroe Street pit now.
Oh, is it now?
Yeah, it was all moved the other day.
Yeah. She said, oh my God, you see it? People just climbing up over it. My dog was in heaven.
No, there was about...
They were loving life out there.
It was about 70 quarter hardwood taken out of there and probably 30 quarter pine. Rest of it was ground up.
Unfortunately, where the seven cord were taken out, and was probably another seven cord.
70 put
through
ground
the,
up.
Put through the chipper, because it's a lot easier for the loggers to chip than it is to put it into a log
right.
length and stack it and everything else. So,
The original estimate on the job, talking to the contractor, the tree company was supposed to be in and out of there in 3 days. 2.5 weeks later, he pulled out. So,
3.5 days is a long time.
Right guy could have done it in a week. But
yeah. Yeah, there was some stuff we saw going through the chipper that,
that should
kind of makes you shudder, because we'd save it, but for them.
Well, yeah, or it could have gone under the residence program for wood,
right? That's
residence.
Where all of it, that's what all of it's sitting up there for.
Yeah. It's a good, great thing. That's a great thing.
It's nice because it gives us money to buy new trees.
Yep. And we don't split as many out, so you know, split wood.
Yep.
That saves a lot.
I think it's time to close, unless you've got something. You want to do these other minutes? Everybody read them?
Oh, has everybody had a chance to review and read the meeting from June 27th?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm good, huh?
Yeah. Who are we accepting?
A motion to approve.
Motion to accept the minutes of June
27th.
June 27th.
2016.
2016. Second.
All in favor?
Aye. One more thing off the books.
That's it.
All right. This goes in the high air.
That goes in the high air folder.
We have a motion by Art to close the meeting.
Second.
Second. Scott? All in favor?
Aye.
I think we should hang around.
Okay. That's a sharpie.